What's up, YouTubers? Tanya here. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today is day 31 of my hashtag InstaFit90 Fitness Challenge. I'm bringing you an intense workout. All you need is a bench, such as that one behind me. A step or a chair will do as well. Anything you can find, stable, that you can step up on. This workout has 5 moves. You'll do each one for a whole minute, 10 seconds in between each move, and a 30-second rest at the end of the round. See if you can get 1 to 4 rounds. And be sure to check with your doctor before starting this or any other fitness program. Pause the next screen while you do a warm-up. Perform each of the moves on the screen for 1 minute each, or any other warm-up you like. Then you can start the workout. Let's do this. Approach your bench and get ready for pistol squats. 30 seconds on each leg. If this is too challenging, perform a regular squat minus the bench. Keep your knee over your ankle. Go down slowly and come up a little bit faster. You can help balance with your arms. When you get to the top of the movement, see if you can squeeze your butt and pull your abs in. For more challenge, pick up some weight. All right, we are halfway through. Switch legs. One side of your body is more dominant, and of course, the opposite side will be more challenged by this exercise, as you can see here. These pistol squats promote a higher level of strength, balance, and mobility. Hang in there, almost done. All right, good job. 10-second rest, and we're on to the next one. Decline burpee with a push-up. Now you'll notice I am walking through the movement here. If you're not good at push-ups, just do a plank. You can place your feet up on the platform and place your feet back down on the floor, or you can add the jump as I am doing here. The jump, of course, will make this exercise a lot more intense. Arms higher will give you a higher heart rate. And of course, you can always go faster to add more intensity. The more intense you are, the more you're gonna burn. If this is too much for you, remember you can slow down. You can take out the push-up and take out the jump. Hang in there, almost done. See if you can get 1 or 2 more. And good job. All right, on to the next one, it's core. Take a seat and let's do those knee tucks. To make this more challenging, bring your arms parallel to your earlobes overhead. It's important to exhale on every repetition and keep your belly pulled in. If you are feeling any strain on the lower back, pull your belly in more. It's possible that you are not engaging your core and that's why you're feeling your back. You can also bring your hands down if you are feeling any discomfort in your back. You are halfway done with these. Keep on going. And remember, you are making your belly flatter. We are training it to go in. In order to do that, you need to be conscious of pulling it in while you're doing this exercise. Hang in there, just 10 more seconds. Great job. We're on to a single leg elevated split plyo lunge. Step your right foot forward about 2.5 feet away from your bench. Make sure your knee aligns directly over your shoelaces and stays behind your toe when bent. You are bending both knees, going as low as possible, and using your arms to pump and counterbalance. Once you get the hang of the movement, you can begin to add the jump. Press into the front heel and keep the back foot on your bench. Your shoelaces are on top of the bench and you are only using the front leg to push and propel yourself up. Excellent. Switch legs and do it again. Remember to step that left foot all the way forward about 2.5 feet. Find your balance. Add the jump whenever you're ready or keep it low impact. Remember to push off that front heel and be sure that knee in front never goes past your toes. Just 10 more seconds, you can do it. Super, you're done. On to incline tricep push-ups with cross knee drives. This one's all about your core, the obliques, triceps, and front deltoid. Exhale on each repetition as you drive your knee across to the opposite elbow. Keep your elbows close to your rib cage and bring your chest all the way to the edge of your bench. Keep your butt contracted when you're in your plank and try to squeeze your inner thighs together as well. You are also keeping your belly pulled up into your spine. Check those elbows. Make sure they're staying close to your body and not flaring out. Also, be sure you are going as low as possible. Try not to collapse through the lower back. Great job, almost done. You got 10 seconds. Hang in there. Great job. You did it. You completed the round. Now drink some water, rest for 30 seconds, and see if you can repeat this workout 1 to 4 times. Everybody hands up, celebrate your victory, and then do your little victory dance. Hey, but wait, if you like this video, don't forget to give me a thumbs up, please, and thank you. Okay, so that concludes our workout, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you got through at least one round. Do some extra ones to make this more challenging. See if you can do 4 whole rounds, all right? Leave me a comment, tell me how many you did. Tag a friend, challenge them to do this workout and come back again tomorrow. Remember to subscribe and go to my Instagram, follow me there too. I'll have the express versions of these workouts there. Quickie little cliff notes. Thanks for watching, bye guys.